repetitive task, so boring, but we need to, because we need to create those environment and installing the tool we need when we develop. But what if we could have something that help us doing it only once and then ship it everywhere? Yes, I'm talking about containers with a S. Let's jump into it. So here I have a typical environment of a developer. We have a database, we have an API, and we have the app that we are working on. And everything is installed on your computer. Here it looks like it's on my laptop. So that's all local. And if I want to change my database or if I want to change something, I need to reinstall it. If someone want to collaborate with me, then they need to install all of that. And when you're not coding, you're just chilling, then all that is also on your machine. So like there's no quick way to say, I don't want a database. You're probably seeing me coming like with the dev container since I share previously how I could have my database or scaffold an API very quickly. So that's exactly that. Today I'm sharing more about that story of me building an app and like how I build things and discover. So it's just sharing some things I found very interesting. So here the difference is the database and the API are in containers. In a previous video, I show you how I put my database in a container, very useful. The link will be up there. And today I want to show you also how you can put very easily the API inside a container. This is the setup I'm using. The app is local on my machine. I'm running in .NET and I'm doing that. I could go and execute that in CodeSpace. I could do that in Visual Studio Code on any platform. I could deploy that in Azure or in cloud very easily, and that's wonderful. You could also decide to push it one more step, and I want to show you that by putting everything in a container, right? You could put everything in a container, and this is perfect. Everything is in container, and like you could change everything, and I will show you the code also for that today, though like I won't go into details. I'm not using that because currently in my application I'm working on, because I'm WebAssembly, so that's why I'm not using it, but it's totally feasible. I did it on a different project. So enough images and blah blahing, let's jump into the code. So in Visual Studio Code I have a folder that is called dev container, just here, dev container. And I like to put my definition there because in my mind it makes sense. And as you can see, I have different Docker compose file, just because depending on the environment, if I just want my database or I want the API. And I did try to have everything. It didn't work for me because, like I said, a WebAssembly, but it's totally possible. So let me show you the one here I have, and it's with the database. So like the two containers, so like the database that I already show you in a previous video, right? We had the MySQL container and like with the script, so SQL script that are executed as soon as the container is start. So then the database is pre-populated. And the other one I want to show you is here, my API box. I know it's a very good name. Thank you. One thing I like about that is here, they have an image. So you could use that data API builder, have just one file. And then what you need to do is specify here, you need to map a volume. And that's how your file, for me here, it's dabconfig.json, you pass it in the app folder. And then as soon as the container start, it will check for this file. If we found it, then it will scaffold that APIs. So just like that, you will have a full API ready to be used. Then of course, because it's requiring the part 5000, you need to map it. And you could put dependency, because if you want to make sure the database is up and running, you could put a dependency, but that's optional if you don't need it. I will show you how to do it with three containers, so stay tuned. But before we go, let's try this environment. I will just want to show you that what I'm working on, is it is working. So just like that, I will open the terminal. I could, in fact, I could do, because I have the Docker extension in Visual Studio Code, I could just go here on my Docker file. We see here, there's that little whale icon. So it recognized by the extension. And if I right click on that, I will have a few options here, and I could totally say, hey, I want to do a Docker Compose app. But let's assume we don't have that extension. I can open a terminal. I can open like a terminal outside Visual Studio Code. I don't need to be inside Visual Studio Code. And then I will just execute this command. Docker Compose, I specify my file up and D for a detach, so I could free up my prompt, my terminal, and like I will be able to type other command. So let's execute this. Should take a few seconds. The image are build, created, spun, start, they read the script, blah, blah, blah. It takes a few seconds because I have different steps. So now if I open a browser and I try to go on localhost Swagger, just like that, voila, have my Swagger file. But Frank, is the database populated and connected to your API? Of course. Let's check the adventurer. So let's do a get. And I will try this. I will execute. And voila, da-da-da-da. I have my two adventurer. It's working. It's pretty cool, pretty convenient. And it's working. So like, to delete, to stop everything, I could just do a compose down and everything will be back to normal. I promise you how to do it with three containers, because for most people, three containers will work and it's awesome. And one of my colleague, Gwen, did a great video also explaining how you could manage multiple containers. I will make sure I link that also, maybe up there or like in the description, but it was a great video. But I want to show you my container. It's that one, voila. So that one. So same start, we have the database server. We have the API box. Can you guess the name of the dev environment? DevBox, yeah. So DevBox, I do a build, so I will show you the Docker file, but basically I just take a basic image from .NET for me. And just like that, I specify dependency on the API. I want everything to be built. This one will be the last one. Important, you map your volume, like your workspace, I mean, so like the code follow. And that's it. You could put them all in, of course, in the same network, so they will be able to talk to each other, but that's it. The most of the detail will be then inside the dev container file. So let's minimize this. I want to show you the Docker file, even if I told you it's just basic image from me from .NET 8. As soon as it came out, I did try that. It was wonderful. And what else? Oh yeah, the dev container. So dev container, you specify how you want to use it. Let's zoom a little bit. You specify if you want any extension. My extension are really .NET focused, since my app is .NET focused. And that's what I really like about those dev container, is depending on the project, you completely change the set of extension you're using. And that's why your environment is always very performant, because you don't have the Markdown stuff if you're not using Markdown. You don't have the .NET stuff when you are doing Markdown. So I really like those things. And down below here, also, yeah. So that's also very interesting, is instead of, how I could say that? It's like, usually you will define the port and the mapping of all those port in your Docker Compose file. But here, because the last container is your dev environment, it's really that one that you're interacting with. This is where you want to open all the part and do the forward. So here, the port for the API, so 5000, and here the port 3306, that was for MySQL. So you do that. And yeah, you do this, and then you will be able to run. So like you just start everything, it will create all the container, you remote in it, like Gwen explained in her video, and you'll be able to have like your three containers, nothing installed on your computer, and be a very productive developer. I hope that helps. For me, it was a very a revelation, maybe not, but it was very, very interesting finding that opportunity to really keep my computer clean and have a very performant dev environment. Share with me in the comments, what are your tips to have a better dev experience? And let's learn. See you next time. Bye.